Okay, this is Sam Smyth Imports, located in Cincinnati, Ohio, 8773 Remington Road. Our telephone number is 513-793-0434. This is an Austin Healey that came shipped in from out of town. It's a BT7 Austin Healey 3000. It hasn't run in several years. So what we're going to do here is show you. We've gone ahead and adjusted the valves. Took the tank out, boiled, repaired, cleaned it. Part of it had disintegrated. Went through the fuel system as needed. Cleaned out the carburetors as needed. For all we know, though, there's no matter how well, unless you replace those lines, you may have to clean those out again. But we did clean all those out. Made all the correct factory adjustments. Cooling system was leaking. Took the radiator out. Of course, it had to be completely serviced and recored. Put that back. We don't like using paint here, especially on radiators that look like this right here. So we also retorqued the cylinder head and again adjusted the valves. We upgraded the ignition system to be a little bit more reliable. I do love points. However, there is electronic ignition. So with testing, the points were extremely burnt. So we decided to replace those points and to go with electronic ignition. And then we upgraded the coil. We've yet to finish the wrapping of the wiring of it, but we did do that. Also, the car had no brakes. The actual brakes it had was all the flex hoses were bad in this car. So those were all replaced because you just hit the brake and all the wheels would lock up. You'd have to open the bleeders to get it to move. So anyway, with that being said, all the flex lines were replaced. All the fluid was dumped. All the wheel cylinders were replaced. Brake calipers were rebuilt. Wheel bearings were cleaned, adjusted, repacked. You got new brake calipers rebuilt on there, rotors. Drums were redone. Drums were actually warped where somebody must have moved it or forgot. Had the handbrake on partially. So they had to be cut and turned so they were round again and would seat in well with the shoes. And then the spring hardware kit, rear adjusters. So with that all being said, this car having sat for several years, we're going to go ahead and turn the key on, start it up, see how it all does. The cooling system, the brake fluid, and the oil, it's all topped up. So let's give her a shot, if you would please. Okay. And there we go. This is done with the electronic ignition now. And it's idling at 400, okay. The technician says. Yeah, if you would show the people, here you go. That's great. Reason why we put out, I mentioned about idling at 400, you can almost see and count the fan blades. Cars that idle extremely high and can't idle low are usually masked with an engine problem and the carburation isn't right, the air-fuel ratio, and the timing's not right. So people have to actually turn the idle up to get them to run. So remember, this may stall now because we did it. It had the wrong fuel pump on it. It was an SU pump, but the original pump is a square body fuel pump. So we put that back on it. So we're just seeing how this car is going to behave. And a 400 idle, wow, that's very, very impressive. And what's the oil pressure at 400 RPMs? It's 60 PSI. So as this warms up to get normal, the best way to check oil pressure is completely hot. And then, of course, if you've got 50 or 60 pounds hot at 400 RPMs, not 4,000 we're saying, 400, you've got an engine, you've got rod bearings and main bearings that are like brand new in an engine here. So anyway, if you could just increase the idle very slowly, see if it will accept our gas through our metering needles and jets, that would be great. There we go. I'm going to walk around the back so you can get, this car has the exhaust system, not the original one, it's been replaced, but it does have the Healey exhaust system, which is going to need replaced. If you can tell, take the idle up just a little bit more, please. There's your Healey tone. The tone that the Healey 3000s are known for, and that is idling at 1100 RPMs. Now the engine, if you look, and you're looking at the fan blades in the engine, it's rock steady, and we're at about 975 RPMs here. And when you start dropping down into 500 and 600s, you won't really hear anything. That's the way it should be. We also don't want to stick a valve. We don't want to break an engine ring. So we do not want to rev this car since it's been sitting. We want to treat it like a new car. We're going to recommend to the people who have this car to do no downshifting for the first 3,000 miles and only upshifting, and then shift at 3,000 RPMs. That way it'll keep the engine, it'll help it brake back in, start running smooth and even smoother without doing any type of damage. Because back in the old days, the tolerances were loose, things were done differently, and you had break-in. So anyway, I'm Sam Smyth, this is Jeremy. We're both technicians on Austin Healey 3000s, from the BT7 through the BJ8 3000s. This one's the Overdrive, this is a one owner. This car has 43,000 original miles. We do a lot of original cars that are brought in from out of town. People want us to handle them, make sure rings aren't broken, parts aren't broken. So if you're in the Cincinnati area, you have questions, you're another shop, ask questions, provide any help or services, please feel free to call us. Again, this is Sam Smyth with Smyth Imported Car Service in Cincinnati, Ohio. Thank you.